It's a beautiful Monday morning, a brand new week, and a brand new day, I have to say. And I want to welcome you to today's edition of Super Dawn on Super Screen Television, UHF 45 and Star Times Channel 173. My name is Olamide Onwuka, and we'll be taking you on the ride this morning. You're welcome aboard.
And of course, a very, very lovely morning to you. It is the 8th day of the month of April. Many thanks for joining us on the very first day of the week. I am Precious Amayo.
Well, it promises to be a very exciting edition as usual. We'll be here to make sure that you are up to date with the latest as far as Nigeria and the rest of the world is concerned. First of all, how was your weekend? It seems short to me. Mine was quite short, though.
I'm trying to understand how the days run. Sometimes, of course, we know that sometimes it's longer days and shorter nights. Sometimes it's shorter days and then it's longer night. Recently, I've been so confused as to whether it's longer days and shorter nights or shorter days and longer nights. But you just realize that all of a sudden it's morning. You have to get up and then again it's morning and you're wondering what's happening. Is it shorter days and shorter nights now?
Whether it's longer day or shorter night, the most important thing that is trending right now is the heat wave that is going on.
The sun is
so angry.
It's terrible.
I don't know. Maybe the sun thinks we're competing with it. Nobody is trying to take the shine away from the sun. The sun is on another level, so we should just have mercy on Nigeria. So, you know,
I think it's a climate change thing. It's been talked about so much. A lot of people don't believe in climate change, but as we continue to live here in it and carry out some activities, we're going to experience a lot of climate change. There was also around Antarctica or the US, I can't remember exactly where, or Canada, but I know there was a large mass of glaciers that melted and that resulted in some kind of flooding. And some tourists were affected by it. Thank God they didn't lose their life because they were on the ice at that moment. So we all have to pay attention to climate change and our activities here on Earth, deforestation, burning bushes. We really have to pay attention to things that we do that is causing this kind of situation.
And not also forgetting the ozone layer depletion.
Yes.
That really it adds to the factors where we were talking about the heat wave around. I mean, when the ozone layer depletes, understand, it's just like reducing the amount of shade you have from the sun, and that's just basically what the ozone layer is about. So it's a beautiful day regardless of the sun. Come rain, come shine, Nigerians will always be Nigerians. We're hardworking, enterprising, and we know that we defy all cause and weather to ensure that we put food on the table of our family. Brand new Monday, good way to set the tone is to start with Super Dawn and get a cup of coffee or tea by your side, and let's just get along together. But right about now, we'll take a break, and when we come back, it'll be time for us to look at the latest on the dailies with a newspaper review segment where we have some papers with us in the studio to take a look at and give you the latest on the daily. Stay with us. Super Dawn continues after this break. Super Screen Television is now on Star Times Channel 173. Now our tentacles are extended to give you the very best of sports, news, entertainment shows, current affairs, blockbuster movies, and lots more. Tune in to Star Times Channel 173 and enjoy the very best of Super Screen Television. Now you're talking.
Super Dawn, your daily live current affairs program where topical issues that border on politics, economy, sport, and sizzling national issues are analyzed, now holds every Monday to Friday, 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. on Superscreen Television. Let your voice be heard. Join us.
Welcome back, and many thanks for staying with us. You're still watching Super Dawn on Super Screen Television. We'll move on now to a newspaper review segment where we'll look at the headlines on the papers. And this morning, as usual, we'll be looking at four papers. And I'll begin with the Nation newspaper, where the headline reads, "Pressure on Goje to accept Lawan for Senate President." Pressure on Goje to accept Lawan for Senate President. Away from that story, Lagos Fire Service Chief, six others abducted. Lagos Fire Service Chief, six others abducted. Smugglers threaten CBN's rice intervention, say processors. Smugglers threaten CBN's rice intervention, says a processor. Senate presidency, erring senators risk expulsion from APC. Senate presidency, erring senators risk expulsion from APC. Five killed, 45 injured in Borno bomb blast. Five killed, 45 injured in Borno bomb blast. Quite a sad one there. Chibok Dapchi representatives visit synagogue to pray for release of Leah Sharibu others. Chibok Dapchi representatives visit synagogue to pray for release of Leah Sharibu others. Ambode reforms pre-launch of $50 million factory in Lekki Free Zone. Ambode performs pre-launch of $50 million factory in Lekki Free Zone. Why we're sticking to Gbajabi Amila on House leadership by Kaduna Reps. Why we're sticking to Gbajabi Amila on House leadership by Kaduna Reps. And still on the Nation newspaper, RMAFC to recover 100 billion naira stamp duties fund from banks. RMAFC to recover 100 billion naira stamp duty funds from bank. And finally, Lawmakers shun audit reports. Lawmakers shun audit reports. And that's all for the Nation newspaper. If you're interested in any of the stories, you can pick up a copy of the Nation newspaper and read through.
Okay, away from that, let's go to the Punch newspaper. Being the eighth day of the month of April 2019, and we'll start with this story. And on the Punch newspaper, Marafa Sani Carpet Yari overuse of charmers to curb banditry. Marafa Sani Carpet Yari overuse of charmers to curb banditry. We have this other one that says insecurity. Ex-APC spokesman wants Buhari to account for $1 billion. Ex-APC spokesman wants Buhari to account for $1 billion and in his coffers. And we have this other one that says, APC says it lost governorship seats for shunning PDP style. APC says it lost governorship seats for shunning PDP style. All right, still on the Punch newspaper, Obi did not introduce zoning in Anambra. Obi did not introduce zoning in Anambra. And in sports now, NFF pledges to assist Aileen Chukwu. NFF pledges to assist Aileen Chukwu. We also have this one that says, Turk allegedly stabs accountant for being disrespectful in Oshun. Turk allegedly stabs accountant for being disrespectful in Oshun State. And finally, on the Punch newspaper, we have this one that says, three sex romp victims were students, says Futo. Three sex romp victims were students, says Futo. And that's the much we can take on the Punch newspaper this morning.
And away from the Punch newspaper, we move on now to the Vanga newspaper, where the headline reads, police arrest cult robbery gang members after shootout in Benue. Police arrest cult robbery gang members after shootout in Benue. Speakership, Benue Plateau members elect endorse Dieg. Speakership, Benue Plateau members elect endorse Dieg. And still on the Vanguard newspaper, Nigeria records a 25 billion naira cyber fraud in 5 years, and that's coming from Sifian. Nigeria records 25 billion naira cyber fraud in 5 years, and that's accredited to Sifian. POS transaction failures threaten cashless policy. POS transaction failures threaten cashless policy, financial inclusion. World Health Day. AGPMPN calls for reintroduction of community health inspectors. World Health Day, AGPMPN calls for reintroduction of community health inspectors. Strikes, NANT urges Taraba government to address lecturers' grievances. Strikes, NANT urges Taraba government to address lecturers' grievances. And on the economy, Ashun is ready for commencement of commodities futures exchange. And that's credited to Ziagu. Ashun is ready for commencement of commodities futures exchange. And that's a statement credited to Ziagu. And now, Bayelsa government sues agri facility over alleged safety check violation. Bayelsa government sues agri facility over alleged safety check violation. And now on to sports. Oshuala paying out of Falcons friendly. Oshuala paying out of Falcons friendly. And finally, on the Vanguard newspaper, still on sports. NFF to support Chukwu's medical treatment. Chukwu's medical treatment. NFF to support Chukwu's medical treatment. And that's all for the Vanguard newspaper.
All right, let's go now to the Daily Trust. And we have this first story there on the... The big story here on the Daily Trust says, kidnapping poses threat to food security business. Kidnapping poses threat to food security business. And the writer to that story says, FG suspends mining activities in Zamfara. Buhari was serious about fighting insecurity. We're serious about fighting insecurity. Still on the front page of the Daily Trust, we have this one that says, Senate Presidency, APC must field one candidate. APC must field one candidate. The details of that story is on page 13 of the Daily Trust. And beside that story, we have this one that says, Oshibanjo returns from Rwanda. Oshibanjo returns from Rwanda. details on page 3. This other one says, Discos gets FG's approval to sell meter at 37,000 Naira. Discos gets FG's approval to sell meters at 37,000 Naira, beg your pardon. You have details of that story on page 17. And now the big picture you can see is that of President Muhammadu Buhari arriving in Dubai for an investment meeting yesterday. And details of that story is on page 3 of the Daily Trust. We have this one that says 11 killed, 43 injured in Maiduguri bomb blast. 11 killed, 43 injured in Maiduguri bomb blast. Details of that story is still on page 4 of the Daily Trust. The same way we have this story, and it says how we were threatened during 2019 polls. That's coming from female candidates. Details on page 14 of the Daily Trust. Lagos Fire Service boss, 6 others abducted. Lagos Fire Service boss, 6 others abducted. Details on page 6. We have this other story, and it says to the back page of the Daily Trust, Ndidi sets new record after appearance against Huddersfield. Ndidi sets new record after appearance against Huddersfield. Details on page 46. Jagielka earns Everton win to stop Arsenal going third. Jagielka earns Everton win to stop Arsenal going third. And we also have this one in sports, and it says Dolofu gets 2 as Watford down Wolves in FA Cup thriller. Dolofu gets 2 as Watford downs Wolves in FA Cup thriller. And then the article here on the Daily Trust says, we bow and tremble before bandits. We bow and tremble before bandits. And it is written by Mahmoud Jega. And details of these and many more stories here on the Daily Trust this morning. So if you're interested in any of the stories, just grab a copy and read through. And with that, we'll come to the end of Super Don's newspaper review segment. But we have a trend here, Precious. Looking at all the stories, which of these ones would you say really interest you?
The one from, it's from actually from yesterday, but it was, I think, the Vanguard newspaper that talked about it, the World Health Day. Yesterday was World Health Day, 7th April. And, it kind of paid, that report paid attention to community health inspectors. But even just in general, the theme around this year was centered, the theme for this year was centered around health coverage for everyone and everywhere. Yeah. And I think that, you know, the earlier we start to talk about issues like that in this country, where everyone has health insurance, but we have a viable health insurance scheme for everyone. Everyone is covered, no one is left, whether people with pre-existing conditions, whether pregnant women, children, mothers, fathers, everyone can be covered by health insurance. We shouldn't have a situation where people are sick and can't afford to go to the hospital. They resort to self-help. We must have a situation where health is, you know, healthcare is accessible and affordable for everyone.
Yeah, that's, I totally agree, you know, because when you talk about the fact that health is wealth, it's a big statement, because the health sector really seem to be lagging in Nigeria. A lot of things, you know, you hear doctors going on strike, you hear Association of Nurses and Midwives complaining about one thing or the other, and, you know, accessibility of healthcare centers and affordability for some people seem to be a lot of problem, because we know how expensive it is to, you know, get the medical bills and other medicines available for you to use just to make sure that you're fine. So I think it's a very good one, particularly yesterday being the World Health Day. It shows that we really need to pay attention to accessibility and affordability of our healthcare centers and sector. So for me, I think the story that interests me the most has to do with the fact that the federal government has given the discos the approval to sell meters at 37,000 Naira. I think it's on the high side, don't you think?
For me, I don't, if it's 37,000 Naira, it's fine as long as it is available. Availability has always been the problem, not price. Nigerians, a lot of people have paid and still haven't gotten their meters today. So as if you're saying that with the 37,000 Naira, it's going to be available, everyone will be metered, and the issues of estimated billings will be done away with, no problem with that, as long as everyone is metered and people don't get outrageous bills at the end of the month, then that's fine.
Yeah, it's fine. Let's just hope that Nigerians are okay with the price. and we're hoping that it's going to be so interesting for us to see how the story unfolds. Precious, newspaper review done and dusted.
Yes, that's too much we can take on the newspaper review segment this morning. We'll take a break now, and when we return, we'll continue our conversation, which was started on Super Dawn Weekend on Saturday. That's the issue of the resignation of the former suspended CJN Walter Onoghen. We know that he has now resigned, and there are a lot of reactions coming up from that situation. But we'll take this break. Our guest is already in the house, so we'll have the conversation, and that conversation will begin after the break.